The pandemic certainly limited the way we travel and conduct business. But despite the challenges, nothing is impossible in pursuit of a dream. This is the story of how a dream aircraft finds its way home in the midst of a global pandemic, while I get to explore one of the world's smallest yet wealthiest nations, Luxembourg. Everyone has a dream aircraft. When I was building our hangar, for me, it was a French three-engine jet, the Falcon 900. I dreamt of having a Falcon inside a hangar, that I had it built just big enough to house one. Over the years, I have almost left that dream behind, until a group of friends and I decided that this specific aircraft met our mission profile. After a long search, we finally found one for sale. But just as we were able to find the aircraft of our dreams, the pandemic hit. The challenge was that the aircraft was all the way in Europe, and getting it to Manila will entail a very long and complicated process because of the global situation. But I was not about to let that get in the way of fulfilling my dream. I was determined to get this Falcon home. Nowadays, fulfilling travel health requirements is the first step anyone should take before departure.
Travel nowadays is not as simple as it used to be. First step I have to do is get a medical, and I am so afraid of this.
Knowing a reputable and reliable clinic to tick off your pre-departure checklist is a must. Kaiser Medical Center offers an extensive list of health services, including the required COVID RT-PCR test. They have complete facilities for any type of diagnostic and laboratory service, including any consultations and checkups one might require. Together with CAAP Inspector Aimer Apao, who will be joining me on this trip, I had to take the dreaded test. I'm glad the people at Kaiser Medical took good care of us. With that part finally over, it was soon time to go to Europe. We arrived in Paris just as they implemented a lockdown. It wasn't the best time to see the City of Lights. But there was business to be done. I went to the Dassault Falcon service where the airplane was brought for the pre-purchase inspection. I wanted to make sure they fix any issues the aircraft may have. Dassault has always been a pioneer in making great business jets. I opted to have it done here since they manufacture the aircraft and would know it inside out. Two of our mechanics were here on training, and it's a pity that they didn't get to enjoy Paris under normal circumstances.
Hey guys, are you excited about your new airplane?
Yes, we're very excited.
Have you been doing well in the school?
Yeah, we're doing well.
Doing well? Studying hard or hardly studying?
A little bit of both. We're enjoying ourselves.
Although it's lockdown, so you guys can hardly go anywhere.
We already went to the Eiffel Tower before the lockdown. So
you're lucky you were able to do that.
There it is, the Falcon 900. This long-range business jet is definitely a great-looking aircraft.
It's always nice to have your first look on the airplane that you really like. I've always dreamed of having one, and here I am, able to come up and step into this airplane that I have been dreaming of.
Inside, the cabin is spacious and well-appointed. Still looks new. The cockpit may not have the latest avionics, but it is more than capable of flying this plane anywhere around the world. Imer does a 360 inspection while I enjoyed looking around.
Ours is not the newest, but I think we'll fill it with love and affection so that it will live a long life and help us enjoy flying all over the world. I was talking to the engineers earlier, and they say that this aircraft is one of the most reliable, and they're very happy to maintain even an older model because they say it's almost perfect now.
After the last of the servicing was done, it was time for the next step, to take the aircraft back to Luxembourg, its country of origin, for the deregistration and tax clearances. Purchasing the aircraft is not a simple process, but we will do anything in pursuit of a dream, right? Up next, I find myself in Luxembourg, one of the world's smallest countries, but in fact, one of the wealthiest, where I continue to go through the process of buying and bringing home an aircraft while discovering this little-known corner of Europe. Still on a mission to bring this Falcon jet home. Buying an aircraft is a complex process, and buying one outside the country at the height of the pandemic is an even more complicated transaction. After being serviced at the Dassault Falcon facility in Le Bourget, it's time to bring the aircraft back to Luxembourg, its country of origin, to iron out some paperwork. After a thorough inspection, it's my first flight on the plane, and I intend to sit back and enjoy it.
It's great being able to fly your own aircraft. I have all the space here, and I don't even have to worry about having any COVID patient in the plane. So this is great. I really enjoy this. And I have plenty of space all the way here to the back. But of course, today, I won't be sleeping. It's a very quick flight, and I'm excited to see Luxembourg.
From Paris, it was only a 30-minute flight to Luxembourg. Luxembourg's compact size can make it easy to overlook for travelers. But this small European nation, bordered by Belgium, Germany, and France, is big in historical sites. Surrounded by powerful neighbors, Luxembourg needed to protect itself with defensive fortresses, building fairy tale-like castles in almost every side of the country. In the Middle Ages, the Counts of Luxembourg became wealthy and influential, and the settlements soon became a small country. Three members of the House of Luxembourg became Holy Roman Emperors, and the fortress city had a strategic position in the heart of Europe. I find myself here, in a brief moment of normalcy, being able to explore the city.
The city is actually built on a natural fortification. So going around town, you'll have to go up and down a lot of steps. Good exercise for me. I'm looking down from the corniche. They say this is the most beautiful balcony in Europe, where you can see the old town.
The old city center is a UNESCO World Heritage Site, said to be a fine example of military architecture over generations. The winding streets are filled with historical buildings and palaces from different time periods, all within walking distance of each other. Luxembourg is the only remaining Grand Duchy in the world, which means it is governed by a Grand Duke or Duchess.
When the Duke is in the city, he resides and conducts business here at the Grand Ducal Palace.
Luxembourg is now a very cosmopolitan and multicultural city. In fact, almost 50% of its population are from other countries. Immigration in droves began in the 19th century and continued to this day. This is apart from the employees from neighboring countries doing the daily commute to work in the city. Because of this, don't be surprised to find different kinds of international cuisine in almost every street. Travelers who find themselves in this part of Europe won't have a hard time finding their favorite dishes from any corner of the world.
You can find any type of restaurant around town, but for me, my favorite is this peppermint because it's a mixture of Vietnamese, Thai, Malaysian. It's very Asian, and they have rice. They gave me some starters. They said this is fried chicken, and I think this is pickled papaya. Looks very good. Let's try it.
This is the tofu.
Tofu.
Vegetable.
Yes.
With Malaysian curry.
Okay.
And this is the beef with the dry chili.
Oh.
And this one, you know, pandan.
Yes, yes.
Pandan. Normally, I draw all the plates.
Oh, I see. Yes.
Shrimp looks good.
Woohoo! With the rice. Shrimp's very good and very fresh. I can feel the spices. It's very tender.
It was great to be able to taste familiar flavors even if I'm far away from home. This high degree of openness to different cultures has also contributed to Luxembourg's robust economic growth. It is currently the wealthiest country in the world in terms of GDP per capita. Crime rate is low, with only 2 jails in the entire country, and it offers the highest minimum wage anywhere in Europe. Luxembourg's national motto, plastered on its old buildings, "We want to stay what we are," is both a statement born of its past and its vision for the future. I'm glad that the aircraft we are trying to bring home allowed me to learn more about this fascinating little country with so much to offer. Up next, join me as I finalize the process of the Falcon purchase until it bears a Philippine registry as it finally finds its way home. The Dassault Falcon 900, a dream aircraft I followed halfway across the world, is almost within reach. Now we have flown it to Luxembourg, where the original owner resides and where they requested the sale to be closed.
We're installing now the ELT, the life rafts, so we can finalize it and make sure in case anything happens to us, we have the life raft. I'm not a good swimmer, so it's good to have it.
The ELT or emergency locator transmitter is designed to transmit a distress signal in case of an accident. The transponder, on the other hand, allows air traffic control radars to identify the aircraft. Since we are now transferring the plane to a Philippine registration, the transponder has to reflect the aircraft's new identity. It's a good thing IMER is with us. As a Civil Aviation Authority of the Philippine inspector, he is the one who made sure the aircraft passed Philippine airworthiness standards and is granted an RPC number. Meanwhile, I also check on the cabin and make sure we have everything we need.
Well, I'm learning all the tricks of the airplane, how to open the door, you know, the electric motors for the cargo doors, and trying to figure out what I need to buy while I'm here. I think I want to complete the wine glasses, the plates, and everything else.
After the ELT and transponder were installed, the plane is towed to a hangar. The escrow payments have been completed, and it's time to deregister the aircraft in its country of origin. It is officially taken out of Luxembourg registry and given a Philippine one. They began to install temporary stickers of the RPC number so that we can fly the aircraft back to Manila.
You know, there's a lot of stages in getting an aircraft and transferring it to your registry. Of course, the first is paperwork, and the last one is when you actually put on your registry. So I'm very happy to see an RPC registered here in Luxembourg. I think it's like the end of all the work. And now the next problem is just getting to fly it back home. But in the meantime, I like taking a picture of it with the RPC.
Pretty soon, the aircraft is now ready to be flown back to Manila. I was able to heave a sigh of relief as my friend Andre arrived to be one of the ferry pilots. We left Luxembourg, and I look forward to stretching my legs and enjoying the flight home.
The plane was flying very well. It's so nice to have the whole cabin to myself. Everything is very comfortable. I have plenty of food, which I will concentrate on a little bit later on. I was a little bit concerned with a lot of things, with the clearances, but everything worked well. Everything looks like it's in good shape. Very thankful to the Dassault Falcon team that kept the airplane the way it should be. We're at 39,000 feet. We still have a distance of about 4,641 kilometers. We've flown for about 1,200 already. So it's looking good. The whole airplane seems to be right. Pressurization is good. Everything is quiet, just like it was a brand new airplane.
We were flying from Luxembourg to Oman, and from there to Manila.
We'll be flying to some of the favorite places that I've been to in the past. And it's nice to see it from the air and reminisce the good times I've had flying over. Well, this one is Santorini. I have visited this last time I did around the world. Interesting to see it again or at this altitude.
I am always entertained watching the different landscapes change while flying.
So here we are now flying over Alexandria. We'll be passing through the Nile, seeing the rest of Egypt. Always interesting to recall the good times I've had with these places. We'll pass through Alexandria, down to Cairo, all the way down to Oman.
Finally, we made it to Muscat. After a refueling stop, we went onward for the home stretch.
Well, we are on the last leg of our journey, and when I look back, it was a very interesting and exciting trip. All the stress trying to get everything together, but I think it's well worth it. Travel nowadays has changed completely. I miss the days when we would fly and really have fun without too much inspection. COVID has indeed changed the way of travel, and I hope it doesn't last too long. The past week of fixing the aircraft documents has been very stressful. A lot of difficulties, different regulations. Of course, we also have to respect what their policies are. Very thankful that I was able to get through all that challenges.
And finally, we were back in Manila, taxiing back to the hangar.
Well, we're finally back in the Philippines and welcoming the airplane to its new home. And we're glad we're able to do everything successfully.
The true test, of course, is bringing it inside the hangar to see if it fits according to the measurements made when we first built it. And it does. Seeing the Falcon 900 parked in the hangar is truly a dream come true. And it just proves that with hard work and patience, you can make your dream a reality no matter how long it takes.
This has been your captain, Joy Roa. See you in the next Asian Air Safari.